Hi students, and welcome back to Bank Exams Today. And in this video I'm going to teach you some tricks and tips for error spotting, and these tricks will be based on the tenses. Like, error spotting comprises of different kind of errors based on tenses, subject verb agreement, conjunctions and many other types of English grammar and parts of speech. So today we are going to start the tenses, and we will do this from the very basics. So let me tell you first what you need to do, or things to keep in mind while you are doing the error spotting based on the tenses. First, you must revise all the rules of tenses, like from the starting to the end. Each rule should be in your mind, and you should revise it every day. If you are weak in English, then you should revise the rule of tenses every day. And the second thing which is closely related to tenses is subject verb agreement rules. So you have to do that also and practice a lot. And for this, I have prepared the videos already that you can see. I'll link the videos in the description section. Then read the sentence you are given and try to analyze the tense, on which tense the sentence is based. Sometimes the activity happened in past, but the tense is given in future or present tense. So you have to analyze the tense and read the sentence carefully, like two or three times. If you don't understand, if it is a long sentence, then if you are again able to find the tense of the sentence, then check if the whole sentence is written in the same tense or not. Like, if the sentence is starting from the past tense, then it should also continue in the past tense. So if the sentence is in present tense, starting from the present tense, then you should end it with the present or future tense as well. And for this thing, you also need to know about the rules of narration. That video we will be doing in the next section or next video. Okay, so I am starting from the very basic examples, and the first one is: the police brought the thief to the villagers so that they can identify them. Now here, the police brought the thief. This part of the sentence is in past. To the villagers so that they can identify them. Now, can is the first form of verb which is present, and we need to know that if the sentence is starting from the past, then it should end from the past also. So can should be replaced by could. The error is in part 3. Clear? Now, the second sentence says, the Punjab police have found the body of a man who they believe to be the prime suspect in a murder case. Here, the Punjab police have arrested a person, and the person was suspected of a murder, or he was a suspect of murder, and Punjab police believed, because Punjab police was believing that the person is accused of, is the suspect of murder. So believe should be in past tense. It should be believed, and the error is in third part of the sentence. Here, if you are unable to find the error, then read the sentence two or three times and try to analyze in which way we are trying to write a sentence or we are trying to speak a sentence. If you read the sentence, you will automatically, if you have practiced the tenses, then you will automatically detect the error easily based on the tenses. So practice is a must. Then the next example says, the house next door was being bought by some new people. Now here, the house is already purchased by some people. So either we will use bought, because house is already bought, the activity has happened in the past. So you should know that if a thing has happened in the past, so we will write it in the past tense of the second form. One more thing we can do here is, the house next door has been bought by some new or some people. Has been is used here to show that we have recently, someone has recently purchased the house. So we can use the present perfect tense here. So we have two options to correct this sentence. The house next door has been bought by some new people, or the house next door was bought by new people. Clear? Then, I am taking care of the garden since my grandfather's death. Now, here we have a time mentioned, since my grandfather's death. And we know that if in a sentence the time is given, either the time is definite or indefinite, we use perfect continuous tense. Either it should be present perfect continuous, past perfect continuous. So here the tense is in present, so we should write it as, I have been taking care of the garden since my grandfather's death. Right? Then Ravi has eaten the cookies last night while watching the match. Now Ravi has eaten the cookies last night. The activity has happened the last night, so it should be in past. So the error is in first part. It should be Ravi ate the cookies. Reading the sentence is a must, because while you read, you will get to know a lot of things about the sentence. So try to read the sentence 2 or 3 times. Then, contrary to earlier predictions, demand for pulses had not increased in recent years. Right? Recent years includes the current year as well. Right? So the action isn't over yet. The activity has not ended here. So contrary to the earlier predictions, demand for pulses has not increased in recent year, because we have, the activity is still going on, or it is included in the present also, so we have to use the present tense. Right? Next, last night the girl in the red dress looks the prettiest. Last night means the time has gone. The girl in the red dress looks, it is in present. So if we have last night in the starting of the sentence, then this should be in the past. So the error is, last night the girl in the red dress looked the prettiest. Clear? Now, the actor talked as if he had already received the award. The actor talked, past tense, as if he had already. We are supposing something, that's why we have used he had. receive the award. Now receive is in present. The sentence is starting from past and ending in present, which is an error. So here it should be received. The actor talked as if he had already received the award. The last sentence says, the municipal corporation has been conducting cleanliness drives everywhere on account of the rising instances of dengue or dengue. Now, in this sentence, we have has been, which is in present perfect continuous. But the rule here is applied incorrectly. We have the rule that present or past or future, perfect continuous, tense should apply the rule has, have, had plus been plus verbs first form and ing. So here the second form of verb is used, which is incorrect. It should be has been conducting, which refers to that the activities still carried on by the people. Right? Now this is the last example. We have done the 10 basic sentences. I hope you have understood the concept. In the next video, I will be moving to some medium level sentences. And till then, you have to watch the tenses and subject verb agreement video, for which I will be leaving the link in the description section. Till then, you have to download the GKit Adjust Android application for the latest videos and updates. And don't forget to click the subscribe button. Keep supporting and thanks for watching.